think a lot of trends that I will be learning because मेरा खुद का fashion background है. I went to NIFT Delhi, so I'm really excited to see what's upcoming and new. Thank you so much. Please सब जाके हराम खोर देखिए और बताइए कैसी लगी. एक वन ऑफ द बेस्ट कॉम्प्लीमेंट्स फॉर मी आफ्टर हराम खोर वॉज व्हेन दिस ऑडियंस मेंबर ही सेड कि मैडम अगर ये रिपोर्ट कार्ड होता तो मैं आपको ए प्लस देता. सो आई थॉट दैट वाज रियली स्वीट. रणबीर कपूर. आई एम एक्सट्रीमली हैप्पी बिकॉज व्हेन एन आर्टिस्ट आप कोई भी काम करते हो तो आप चाहते हो कि पूरी दुनिया काम देखे. तो एंड फाइनली हराम खोर आफ्टर फोर इयर्स ऑफ बैटल्स विद द सेंसरशिप एंड एवरीबडी तो रिलीज हुई है. तो इट वॉज अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड बिग डील फॉर अस. तो हमने फिल्म इज मेड अंडर अ करोड़ और हमने ऑलरेडी एक करोड़ बना लिया है. सो दैट्स ग्रेट. लाइक बाकी फिल्म से कंपैरिजन में अ करोड़ इज नथिंग बट फॉर अस अ करोड़ इज अ लॉट. सो इट्स वेरी ओवरवेलमिंग एंड दैट्स व्हाई आई कीप रिक्वेस्टिंग पीपल टू गो वॉच बिकॉज एवरी टिकट मैटर्स. There are scripts which I'm reading, so hopefully, fingers crossed, there should be some good news soon.
Nawaz sir, से क्या कुछ सीखने को मिला
आपको? अरे Nawazuddin Siddiqui he's one of the best actors we have, and वो इतनी space देते हैं for to the co-actor that you learn and grow a lot. So I would love to work with him again and again.
If we talk about Nawaz promotion की बात करें आपसे, बहुत कम जगह दिखाई
दी आराम के लिए. अरे नहीं नहीं वो बहुत ही बिजी. इनफैक्ट वो दुबई में थे एंड मैंने बहुत सारे इंटरव्यूज़ किए उनके साथ और इतना मज़ा आता है क्योंकि उनका वो बहुत ही विटी एंड इंटेलिजेंट इंसान है. तो हम पूरे हमने काफ़ी दिन किए थे इंटरव्यूज साथ में. थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू.
this because I'm not a fashionista, but you know, it's great that this happens every year. And Elle basically celebrates this every year, where you know they have young, some of the most brightest young fashion talent who are bringing about a change and bringing change in the Indian fashion and giving it a, showing it a different direction. So it's really good to see new talent being given a chance and opportunity. And it's a huge platform, I feel. Elle is a huge magazine, and they have a really, I mean, their popularity is on a like a really wide scale. So it's really good to see young, bright people getting an opportunity.
What quality would you say to the models and for judging?
I'm sorry?
Kya kya qualities dekhungi models mein judging?
Kya kya qualities main dekhungi while judging? I'm honestly fretting right now. Pata nahi main kaise karungi kyunki mujhe fashion ki itni knowledge nahi hai. So whatever as a commoner I like, and whatever sense that I have of fashion, what I like as an individual, I'm going to judge on the basis of that.
Rukmani, as a fashion event, who are you wearing today? Is it like a dress?
Yes, Rahul? Yeah. Payal Khanna, right?
Payal Khanwala.
Khanwala, sorry. Yeah. Payal Khanwala, please we can edit that.
Yeah.
Payal Khanwala.
Khanwala.
After the Red Racing
one. Oh, sorry. Then
after the baby, what movie will come?
What are your future projects and what are the plans? Any film that you have signed, because all the fans are excited. We've seen you in Day 50, we loved you in Day 50.
Thank you.
But what next? What is next for
one? Abhi, there's nothing that's planned yet because, you know, I'm reading things and I'm seeing nothing signed. So there's nothing that I can talk about. But whenever there will be, then I'll make an announcement.
Hear ki, Aditya sir is keen on signing you for Dhoom 4, which also has Shah Rukh.
I hope that happens. It's a fantastic rumor, which I hope turns into reality. But I have no idea, yeah. I don't even think Adi has an idea about directing Dhoom 4 yet. But I don't know. Don't quote me. But I don't know. I'm not in it as of now.
Speaking about Befikre, what do you want to say about the response that the audience has given to the film? Are you happy with the response?
I think it's got polarized reviews, where there are people who've loved it and there are people who have not really, they've not really felt connected to the film the way one thought they would. But I feel it's also to do with the fact that it's a little bit ahead of its time. It's got polarized reviews, but I feel it's just a light-hearted romantic movie, which was it's a romantic comedy, and I don't know what else can be expected out of it. But all I know is that I mean there are people who've really shown a lot of love for the film, and we're just like, I'm just counting that.
Mari, during the film promotions, it was a sad thing that, you know, and even you spoke about it in an interview that, you know, people are speaking something, you've done something to your face and all. But what do you want to say about the things that...
I don't want to say anything. I just want to go bang my head against this wall because I'm done answering. You guys feel I've done something.
You answered in a print interview, but for electronic medium, you haven't given a bite. That's what I'm asking you here.
You know, by giving...
Me? Okay.
I really don't want to comment here because I feel by commenting I'm giving so much importance to those few people who are coming up with such statements, which is really ridiculous for me to even answer, because I feel I'm giving, it's just irrelevant for me.
Which movie are you looking for? Looking to see forward, Rais or Kabir?
Both films. I'm a big movie buff. I want to watch both. And I'm a big Shah Rukh Khan fan, and I really, really love watching Hrithik on screen. So I'm anticipating both films.
Did you see Dangal? Yeah.
I have. It's an amazing film. Again, Aamir Khan and all those girls and everybody in them. You can't pinpoint anything wrong in that film. I think it's just an all-rounder winner.
Honey, speaking of Dangal, do you think Aamir is like the best Khan of the three Khans that are there? Because all his films get a good critic response also, and it does good business also.
I don't think you should compare artists. Every artist has something unique about them, and they all bring something so different to the, to the film and to a certain character. So I don't think you can... I wouldn't want to compare anybody with anyone.
But personally, do you?
Personally, I love watching everybody. Yesterday, I was watching. There was the Dilwale Dulhania coming, and I only got to see the climax bit, and I saw Shah Rukh's this really expressive, just by by his facial expressions, he was interacting with Amrish Puri, and I fell in love with him. And I was like, oh God, he's just magic on screen. Yeah, we should not be commenting. Like, I'm here at
the end. And she has written about the apology also. Could you please speak about it? Wow. And even Amir has come in support of it.
I'm honestly.
She has said that don't consider me as a role model.
See, other thing is that I have to apologize. I'm a little unaware of it. But I would honestly would want to even comment on this platform where I'm supporting the new fashion designers and talking about somebody else's thing and, you know, creating controversy. So I'd speak about it, but on another forum.
This is my first time that I'm walking for the LA Awards red carpet, and I'm super super excited because I've heard a lot about LA Awards. Of course, everybody knows about it. So I'm just here to watch the show and enjoy the show. I have heard about the participants, yes, and of course I'm here to support them. Of course, I'm here to watch the show. I've always been into I used to do modeling a lot, so it's always it's kind of exciting to be a part. What do you think how I am? Yeah.
What's your personal styling?
My personal styling?
Yeah.
Honestly, I would not say anything on that. I mean, I can wear as comfortable clothes I want to, but because of course it's Elle Awards and everyone, it's about fashion, so I just thought to look
what's
as fashion. Today I'm wearing Bhakti Joshi. Bhakti Joshi, because that's the gown I'm wearing right now, so of course I'm going to speak about it.
According to you, who is a fashion icon? According to you?
According to me, I think Sonam Kapoor. I really like her. I like Malaika Arora Khan. They are like so sexy.
Any message you have for your fans who follow you rigorously on Twitter and wait for your picture?
I'm going to tell them that I'm here in LA Watch tonight and this is what I'm wearing. I hope it's perfect. Just to tell you guys, I'm here and be on Twitter to watch everything what I post.
Thank you. excited. Like, I think every woman or girl is over here because his fashion is a god we really worship. So I'm very excited, you know, especially because I want to see something new, something fresh, and you know, something. I mean, we need something new right now. So I'm kind of like really excited to see what these guys have gotten up with, and you know, like what the new colors are, the styles are, the fabrics are, and ensembles, and that's how anybody comes to one of these.
Are you going to judge the show?
Am I going to judge it? Oh God, no! I could never judge clothes. I think fashion is the most amazing thing, obviously. So no, I could never judge it. I worship it.
What real meaning of fashion for you?
Something, I think fashion for me is whatever I wear, it should make me feel a certain way, you know? That's how I wear my clothes. Like generally speaking, there are times where I'm in a bad mood, I'll wear pajamas. But that's because my clothes make me feel good, you know? And that's basically what it is for me. What you wear is how you feel, you know? I mean,
Can you tell us what is going on your pipeline? What is the upcoming project?
I'm doing a film. I'm doing two films with Deepak Tijori. Another one's called Tipsy. There's also like a little non-commercial film called Kalua that I'm doing. And there's one film I've just finalized on, but I've not signed it yet. So I'll wait before I say that. But yeah, I just finalized my fourth movie. So
thank you
so much, Jesse. You've been lovely. Thank you.
Something as usual, which will be super amazing because Elle is always amazing, so I'm looking forward to it.
Right, what is it that you're exactly doing inside? Are you judging or are you gonna walk the ramp?
You'll have to wait and find out, to be honest. But I'm really happy and really excited to be here. I always love being part of all the Elle events, I love shooting for the magazine, so I'm very happy to be here.
Kapoor and Sons won a lot of awards.
Yeah, I was so happy. Yeah.
So, what do you want to say about it?
I'm so proud of Shakun and Aisha. You know, they were absolutely amazing. Like, Shakun was really hands-on when I was doing my role as well, and so was Fawad. So I'm just so proud that I was there at Film Fair with them when they scooped the awards.
After Kapoor and Sons, what's upcoming
project? Both Hollywood and Bollywood, actually. So I'm very excited.
Anything specific that you've signed on which you'd like to share with us?
I'm not allowed to until they give the official press release.
Okay, thank
so
you.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Our film's releasing Mona Darling in a month, 17th of Feb. So we are all here together to. It's the first time we are out actually.
This is the first
time
we are out together. All
yeah,
three
after
of
the
us.
Trailer launch. So if you guys have not seen it, please see the trailer.
Okay, I'm Susanna Mukherjee.
Anshuman Jha, Divya Menon. And we are a cast of this upcoming whodunit thriller called Mona Darling by Shashi Surigala. Vashu Bhagnani is releasing it. The trailer's out. So we are here to have fun and see some good fashion.
Yeah. How the responses come from?
The trailer has been phenomenal. We went viral actually the first day of release. We were trending Twitter.
We've
for
had
seven
1
hours.
Million hits.
And we had 1 million for a
Reels.
Small film with a young cast. I think it's amazing.
A million hits within a few days. It's amazing.
3 days, yeah. Sanjay Suri is in the film. So it's Susanna, Divya, Sanjay sir, and me.
How was the experience of working together on this film? On the first film?
Oh, it's not. My first film was LSD. Her first film was Byomukesh Bakshi. Her first film was...
It's a while ago now.
Yes. So we are both Dibakar Banerjee launches. Yes. And it was nice. It was... it's a very good script. It's a very good director we worked with. He's Nagesh Kupunur's associate, Shashi Surigala. It's his second feature. He's made an independent film before this. And it's a genre we are all very excited about because Indians love thrillers and whodunits. It's just that... This is the first of its kind.
And it's the first social media thriller of India. So,
yeah.
We are
so
all
the whole hook in the film is the social media. So that way, yeah.
So speaking about tonight, are you guys like walking the ramp or
like, no, we are not.
No, yeah, I don't. I think they are good enough to walk the ramp. I'm not. But
but yeah, I think
we are watching.
We'll catch the show.
We'll catch the show.
Yes,
we're looking forward to seeing some.
And this is our first night together, so we should.
Yeah,
we're
very excited. After the shoot tonight, we've got together after. After 6 months
really
or so, 6-7 months. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
So
much. Thank you.
Thank you.
I've just come to attend this moment of fashion oozing out totally throughout the show. Of course, there are so many designers who are showcasing their design, and I think fashion is something which always goes hand in hand with films, and even as a person, I think everybody wants to be fashionable today. And somewhere, just not the actors, but I think even common people, girls, common boys have become so fashionable when I see them. So I think it's very inspiring to see what's new. And I think I just love fashion, so I think I just enjoy this evening, such evenings, yeah.
Sana, what's your first fashion style?
Well, I think it just depends depends on the kind of body I have at that point of time and the outfit that fits me perfectly and shows me beautifully. So I think, yeah, something which is comfortable at the same time, something which has some nice fashion and looks a little different. So, yeah.
After the Vajra Tumo, so what is your upcoming projects coming?
Well, you'll get to know in a week now.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm just kind of looking forward to the show, and it's just great to be here. And Elle's obviously a great magazine, and you know, it's the issue is always around the house and stuff with Sonam and Ria, and so it's just cool. You know, I really like kind of getting ready for events, and it's fun. You know, it's a nice break from, you know, when you're doing overtly intense films, it can get very like. You know, demanding and challenging and stuff. So it's a nice, it's something. It's just good for your head, you know, to come out, have a nice evening, meet some people that you haven't seen in a very long time.
Also, we hear you're judging inside. If I'm not wrong, the fashion.
I don't think so. No.
Okay.
No.
Okay. So you're just gonna chill and have a good time. That's all.
Yeah. Yeah. Just have a good time.
Congratulations for the awards.
I didn't win it, so you don't have to congratulate me. No.
But how do you feel? So, how do you feel? Were you expecting that?
Look, yeah, I mean, if I say something, then you guys are going to make a big deal out of it.
No, but it's an honest question. Like, were you?
Look, you win Stardust.
I know, I won everything except
Filmfare. Yeah.
So,
yeah.
I think, you know, see, you don't really know what kind of goes into it. Like, some awards have a jury, and then they decide. Some have a popular vote.
Yeah.
So, I don't really know how they decided this year.
Mm-hmm.
But I think, you know, I think debutante awards should be for people that are relatively new to films and have done kind of less work. That's like, it's like, otherwise it's like saying I've done 100 English films and now I'm doing a Hindi film, so I'm a debutante. So if Leo DiCaprio once wins an Oscar and then comes to do a Bollywood movie, he's a debutante, which is not, I mean, it's not something I agree with. But I mean, I think, look, you know, I have Bhavesh Joshi and I have... another film that I'm doing that's a biopic that I'm starting at the end of the year. Now, as you grow, you keep working on your craft and you keep getting better as an actor, right? But at the end of the day, if people don't connect with the narrative of the story, it kind of takes away. People feel then your performance isn't what you think it is.
Yeah.
But to in terms of myself, I've rewatched Mirza several times, and there's not a moment I can really change about that film. Now Bhavesh Joshi might come out and, you know, it might connect with people more because of the plot and it's more relatable. So people may think that's a better performance, but that may not be the case. So it's so subjective and it's so greatly dependent on opinions. But I was very disappointed not to win, to be very honest with you.
Yeah.
And I'm very sorry, but I'm a very honest person. And so if you ask me the question, I'm going to answer it, you know. So very, very disappointed not to win, and I'll be back. Don't worry.
So is it true you're working with Vikram Aditya Motwani?
Yeah. So we've almost finished shooting that film. We have about 20 days of shooting left, and then the film should release sometime towards the end of the year.
Harsh, tell me, Zaira Wasim, the Dangal girl.
Sorry, yeah.
Zaira Wasim, the Dangal girl, has been trolled just for meeting Mehbooba Mufti, and she has written an apology.
I don't exactly know what happened. I saw a little bit of it on social media, but I don't want to have an opinion on something I don't have enough information about. So it would be very wrong for me.
So Sonam won an award for the best critics. What do you want to say about that?
Well, I think she should have won the main category, to be honest. Because if you're saying popular, then Nirja is the highest grossing female film of the year. And in terms of popularity, its reach is massive.
Right.
You know, I don't understand how it really works. I mean, it's great that she won an award. But I mean, it would have been nice if it was best actress. Yeah,
so. And you know, two big films are coming up, Kabul and Rais. Like, which one are you
looking forward to?
I'm looking forward to both. Ritik really saw Mirza and really said some very genuine and nice things about the performance. And we've spoken after that. And he's obviously really busy with the film, so I'll probably go and meet him after. As for Rais, I think, you know, after Dangal has done such massive numbers, if Rais does well and Kabil does well, then the industry is truly well and back to where it belongs, you know. And that's where really, because then what happens is a couple of films do the numbers and everything changes, you know. And I have a feeling that both the films are going to do really well, you know. Between the two of them, I think that they're going to be some big collections. You know?
You spoke about Dangal, and you know, Harsh, because you're an honest person, I want to ask you, do you think Amir is like the best actor that we have around right now? Because his films get a good commercial response also, and
right.
Critics also appreciate it.
Well, I think, you know, there is a certain advantage of doing one thing at a time. Like, look, Mirza may not have worked out at the box office, but in terms of attention to detail and its visuals and its music, it's, you know, you can... You do realize that we've taken that amount of time to make the film. And with Amir, he really invests so much in each character, in each part. You can see how authentic it is and how thought through it is, and it's still very felt. Because what happens a lot of times as an actor is when you think about things too much, then it doesn't feel spontaneous. But he manages to kind of get the best of both worlds, you know. And look, I think it's the finest performance by an actor this year. I think Sushant was amazing in Dhoni also. And I also think Shahid was very good too. So I think those are the three best performances of this year.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.